Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Today we have another critique video of your guys' artwork. For those of you guys who are unfamiliar with the series, we critique your guys' work when you use the hashtag ABCrit over on Instagram. It's that easy. It says this was uploaded April 4th. Homie, I never saw this until today. Like, literally, man. If I would have seen this before, I would have definitely thrown this in. Dude. When I saw the thumbnail for this, before I even knew who it was from, I'm like, I'm gonna include this just to show it off. I have nothing to say about this. There is literally nothing to say. But what I do want to point out, and it's only because me and a friend in Twitch, we were talking about this recently, where they asked me, what is it called when someone does a one-letter piece? And I said it's pretty much just called a one-letter piece. But if you follow up that one-letter piece with the rest of the letters, really small in comparison, then this... the heavy stylized first letter is called an illuminated piece, or an illuminated letter, or an illumination. Which comes to us from calligraphy, and you'll see that in like the super fancy text where like they have the crazy aesthetic, you know, for the first letter and then the rest of the paragraph. This is really dope. And I got nothing to say for you here, man. This is, I mean, I don't have a critique. Dude, what are you're killing it, man. Literally, the one thing I would have done differently is I would have left a little negative space right here. I would have ended this 3D, I would have ended it right there. Just so we have some negative space and some depth building from this 3D overlapping the one that would have ended here and some negative space right here. That is the only thing I would have done differently, because this is phenomenal work. Yo, look at this. Look at this. What's up with this guy? He's got like a box head. I like this, man. I like this. What I would say is work on some atmospheric perspective, right? That can really help push your focal points and your not focal points, and just, you know, really push the atmosphere of an image. Think of like the Godzilla movies, or maybe even like the Cloverfield movies, where there may be a big ass creature all the way in the background and you can't really see it because there's like a mist, or there's like some kind of atmosphere between you and them. Or even in some horror films, it helps build tension, or at least builds curiosity, and it also allows for the person to have a focal point. So here, immediately my eye goes to this because it's the highest point of contrast, right? You have harsh white, harsh black, and then a pretty, you know, light green down here with a dark green up here. So there's a lot of contrast going on there. As to where there's not much contrast here other than the colors, so my eye definitely shoots there, don't get me wrong, but my eye goes bam, bam. And what ends up happening is these two things end up kind of competing to be a focal point, and you don't want that. You want one definitive focal point, and then one to assist it. And with atmospheric perspective, you could have pushed the background further in the back, so you can still tell the same story, but with more atmosphere. That's some good stuff, man. That's some good stuff for sure. Keep it simple, Wolfie Gruff. Keep it simple. Don't get me wrong, you have some things that are good in this piece. For example, the eye is pretty good, right? These compressed extensions that you have are pretty good. And the chips are actually really good. The chips are very well done. And the 3D is even well done. Although you do tangent in some areas with 3D, for example, right here and that. But it's still good. But things such as extensions, letter structure, letter and name, weight, these things still need a lot of work. Your hand style, all of these things still need a lot of work. And you're not really ready for extensions at the moment. As I've said in the extension video and multiple critiques, your extensions have to flow out of the origin, which this is pretty tacky. They have to have a reason for the travel distance, which this doesn't, and has to flow into the destination, which you could argue that this kind of does. This flows out of the origin, but doesn't really flow in the destination, has absolutely no reason for travel distance. This does not flow from the origin or the destination and has no reason for the travel distance. So you're not quite ready for extensions yet. Keep it with compressed extensions, keep it basic straight letters. More so like this. This is good. Keep it with this. Simplify your hand style, get rid of the arrow. Make all of these letters about the same size, and work on refining your letter structures. Don't too much worry so much about style, really refine letter structures. As we can see with like this little bump in the W right here, and this little wave in the W right there. So definitely refine letter structure, keep it simple. Look at this right here, Christy Holden, you always got some pretty good work. Now I don't really paint animals too much, but what I can say from people I have seen paint animals is you wanna start with the darker fur colors first. Right, so establish those areas, and then you can do the lighter fur colors on top of that. That's gonna really help build the depth of that fur. That's gonna really help you sculpt those forms and make it look more realistic. And we see this happen again in your pug piece as well, where you have the mid-tone, and then you have the dark on top of that, and then you have the light on top of that, but in some areas, it looks like you put the dark on top of the light, like in this area right here. What I would do is give yourself multiple values to work with. So come up with your darkest fur, then like your second darkest, your third darkest, your mid-tone fur, then your third lightest, your second lightest, and then your most light fur. Try to break it up like that and do it exactly in that order so like that you can really build it up over time. Really great job on the eyeball, by the way. Phenomenal job there. I really like that a lot. Here's a great example for one of my favorite artists, Greg Simpkins, where if we take a look at this fur on the finger, you can see how he painted the darker ones first, and then he goes ahead and hits with a slightly lighter value, and then he goes with the highlight on top of that. And you can clearly see that order that builds depth. And that's not only the only time you'll see it. If we look at this Cheshire the Cat, you can easily see it here as well. But the highlights and the lighter fur are more so used like kind of like a stippling technique, where you don't have to do it throughout the entire thing. You can kind of peter it out when you want it to fade away. And you can see that over here in the hand area, where there's more highlights here, and then it kind of gets less as you get around the finger. And there's, once again, more highlights here, and it becomes less as you get further back. So that's what you'd want to do. You'd want to peter it out. And even though, mind you, you don't have to use this highlight color all the way over here, but as this gets darker, you may be able to use a darker color as a highlight in super dark areas. For example, this reflective light on Spider-Man's chin is darker than this highlight, but it's still lighter than the shadow, so it makes a good highlight here. But this value, that reflective light, would end up shading this if I were to put it there. Hopefully that makes sense. Spaz, good stuff, good stuff. Now some of you guys are probably wondering, like, why is he saying good stuff to this simple piece? I know how some of you guys are in that comment section. Don't be rude, but he's keeping it simple. He is keeping it simple. He's doing exactly what he should be doing. Practicing the basic letter structures. Yes, he still is stylizing in some way where instead of having a one box S that's all round and curvy, he has a three box S, which I would say go for the more round S just so you can kind of refine that letter structure a little bit and you don't have to distort other letters for the sake of that S. But you did a good job with this. And the reason I say that is because although you did make this a sharp S, you managed to keep all of the other letters uniform and flowing. So they all go together and you did a good job with that. I would say maybe make the S bottom a little thicker if you're gonna have the top leaning that far. It's important in order to balance the individual letter as well. Also for the A, I would have moved it slightly over to the right and made it taller. You want it to be about as high as the S. And that goes for all of the letters, not just the A. And then the Z, you could have used a little bit bigger of a Z. It's a little bit small comparatively, but it's still not bad. Good job on keeping it simple. When we take a look at your other work as well, we see that, yes, you are keeping it simple most of the time. I guarantee you, Spaz, if you continue keeping it simple, you'll see massive improvements and you'll get better faster than everyone who isn't keeping it simple. 10 years down the line, when you're doing crazy wild styles, all people who don't keep it simple will be confused and wondering why they're not getting better. Then they'll think back to this video and go, man, I should have listened to John and I should have kept it simple. You might notice that this part is being recorded on a different day because I kind of forgot to record an outro. So welcome to the end of the video, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget, this video is sponsored by Skillshare.com. You can learn to do a crazy amount of things over there, and I have a link for 2 free months in the description. Go ahead and sign up, it's completely free, and you can quit whenever you want. For those of you guys who'd like to submit, it's real easy, just use the hashtag ABCrit over on Instagram. And if you're new here, join the family by subscribing. We come out with weekly art videos. I'll see you guys next time, but until then, peace.